Hello all. Once again, I'm Gary with Sunshine Ministries. A lot of you know me, a lot of you don't. But God bless each and every one of you. This message was one that almost wasn't, because I have a little confession to make. And Satan speaks to all of us, as you know. I went to looking back on some of my prior videos that I made, and well, of course, my eyes focused right away on the little section that says comments. See, this is where Satan was leading me. And I got to looking at those comments and went down, scrolled down, scrolled down, and it was either one, two, or three. Usually just one or two. Sometimes three, and once in a very blue moon, four. So, and being aware that these videos are going all the way around the world, or at least two-thirds of the world, I'm thinking, or the devil's thinking, or wants me to think, that, you know, out of all these people, you've got three responses. One would, of course, be from my blessed wife, Bonnie, wonderful woman of God, my blessed wife. And I praise God for her each and every day. The other would be my dear sister-in-law, Jenny, not only do I just love her to death, she's, you know, such a wonderful woman of God as well. And, yeah, I always get responses from her. And we also share a friend, a dear friend and brother in Christ, Donnie. And, well, he's really not online that much, so, but when he is, you know, I'll get a response from him. And then, like I said, once in a very blue moon, then I would get one from a total stranger, but that hardly ever happened. So I'm thinking, well, you know, what's the use? Why bother? And that's exactly what Satan wanted me to think. Why bother? Not doing any good. You're not helping anybody. You're not blessing nobody. You're not leading anybody to the Lord. That's exactly what Satan wanted me to think. But you know what? God said, I want you to go back and look at those again. And it's almost like he took his very finger and pointed to that little section that says views. You know, views. And there are so many. And then I thought to myself, well, how many things have I watched on YouTube or anything else for that matter? And even though it hit home, how many did I actually go back and comment on? I got to thinking about that, and I'm hardly ever. You know, regardless of, you know, how it touched me, I just, and I'm being honest, and I very seldom did. So, see, this is what's telling me the people are running across, and hopefully a lot of them are watching, and there may be, and hopefully, prayerfully, a lot of these people are running around with new life, you know? So, the devil has, you know, lost once again, and it looks like you guys are stuck with me. So, I know that made your day. Yeah, but I'm going to keep doing this. I'm going to keep magnifying and glorifying God's name until I no longer have breath in my body. As long as I'm above ground, and even when, after they throw dirt on me, if I'm able to minister down there, I'm going to do it. But let's get to the message, which once again, most of you, or all of you, know that some of my messages can be, to say the least, a little bit off the wall. I've had a few people comment on my manner, my calmness, my demeanor. Why am I not jumping up and down and cutting backflips and screaming at the top of my lungs? Well, I'll describe that the best way that I can. There are many Christians. I'm not talking about carnal Christians. I'm talking about people that, I'm talking about newborns. Just talking about Christians, just carry this fire, this very visible, you know, each and every day. And glory be to God, you know, we're all different. I'll give you an example, a newborn. And I know that 90% at least of you have been around a newborn Christian. 100 miles an hour, you cannot shut them up. But who on earth would ever want to shut them up? Because they're just going on and on and on and on what God has done, you know, for them. That Jesus had reached out, joined the family, you know. What miracles have already happened, what's already transpired, and they just go on and on and on and on. It's so wonderful, and it just never dies. Now, as far as me, personally, yeah, it's still there. No, I'm not cutting back flips. I guess to be more blunt, I guess you could say I'm just spoiled rotten, because I know, you know, I'm part of God's family. And the most wonderful family in the universe. And I'm trying to find another word besides spoiled, but that's about the best I can do. I'm just adjusted. I love my new life, and I can't even imagine myself without Christ in my life. But my nature, or my manner, or demeanor, or whatever, is calm, because this is calm, and I've adjusted. Not that I take God for granted, don't misunderstand, it's just that I'm content. And years back, I couldn't even say that with a straight face, because I'd be lying. I'm going to move along a little bit, and of course, like I said, and all of you know, aside from the funny little skits once in a while that I throw in, that normally my videos are a little off the wall, and this is, of course, no exception. I'm going to ask every one of you right now, do not think about a banana. Now, I will guarantee you that 99%, if not every single one of you, didn't visibly see a banana, but back here, you saw this little flash of a banana. You know, some of you probably tasted it, you know? Not here, but you tasted it here. Or if I were to say to you, I do not want you to think about the autumn leaves, the ones the ones that fell in the autumn leaves, what they smell like when they're burning. Of course, right away, the first thing that you saw was a little flashback here. And you can smell it with that. But you actually smelled it, those leaves burning back here, even though I asked you not to. You know, didn't do any good not to ask you to, because that back here just grabbed right a hold to it. If if a song comes on the radio and it goes off, and then I start singing a few bars from it, and then next thing you know, you're walking around the rest of the day, and the song is stuck in your head, and you just can't get rid of it. Okay, now right about now, this is the point to where most of you say, okay, where is this idiot going with this? Well, I've grown accustomed to that, and I will get back to that in just a few. Now, one thing I want to ask, or want to point out, or whatever be the case, okay, I ask myself, how do I know which voice is speaking to me? How do I know? Well, Satan will speak to your mind, okay? He'll speak straight to your mind. He is not stupid, but he is the biggest liar. Jesus speaks to your heart. And if you listen with your heart, with an open mind and an open heart, you'll know. I promise you, you will know the difference. So as I promised, we'll go back to the banana thing. So now, how do you get rid of it? That banana is just, you know, stuck in your head. So how do you get rid of it? Well, you start thinking about an apple. That apple is what, how God has blessed you, what he's done for you, all the miracles, and just how wonderful God is. Well, then see, when you do that, when you start thinking about that apple, you forget all about the banana, don't you? And then you just slam the door right on Satan, and he's done. Because you're thinking about the apple. And, you know, Satan's going to haunt you, and it will haunt you with that banana all day long until you redirect your thoughts completely to that apple, which is the voice and the will of God. Now, here's one that a lot of people, you know, give me a lot of flack over. Don't agree with me, but dreams. Jesus speaks, when he speaks to you in your brain, it's during stillness or sleep. You know, and many believe that dreams are, you know, kind of like a screensaver. They just keep your mind active while you're sleeping, but I don't think so. The dreams that you remember vividly, you know, no matter how far-fetched they are, it could have been something that happened yesterday, but there always seems to be something added to it. What you need to do is, those ones that you remember, as you dwell on them, and ask God to help you to analyze exactly what that dream meant, because I truly believe that there is a message, and this has worked for me in the past. And I'm not just telling you because this is some kind of a new wave or something, but there's a hidden message in there that Satan cannot understand. Those dreams that you get, that you just forget the very instant that you wake up. Well, I also believe that's for a reason. And I use the screensaver as an example, as, you know, most can relate computer-wise these days. You know, most people have computer knowledge, and I always try to find a language that I can, you know, make people understand, or do my best anyway. These dreams, the very second your eyes open, you just forget everything. See, I believe that these dreams are put away in a hidden or zip file because you're going to need them in the future. The phrase deja vu, which I'm sure that everybody's familiar with, there's an old group, Crosby, Stills, and Nash, for those of you know, that was one of their smash hits. But the phrase deja vu is like you've been somewhere before. And in my true belief, this is where these files are open. You know, because, okay, it's come to time that where you need this, which was instilled in that what you couldn't remember before but was released from your subconscious where God had implanted it. So therefore, you would know how to deal with it. Of course, you get that eerie feeling like, oh, I've been here before. Well, you certainly have. You have been there before. Pardon me, please. I'll give you a for instance. I'm from Charleston, South Carolina. And back in the day, of course, all the homes down there is the old colonial homes. And today, when they build a house, they build it, they build one and they make a copy and then they build 1,000 more just like it. Well, see, they didn't do that back then, especially in Charleston. Every single home, these Victorian houses, were built differently. There was always something different about them. Some may have a similarity here and there, but pretty much all were different. I did a lot of work down there, and sometimes there were, you know, outside of work when I entered these houses for the first time, that I could tell you where everything was in that house. Everything. Because I had been there before. It's a vision from God. Okay, now, let me ask you, are you confused yet? I have a habit of doing that with people, so if you'll just hang on and bear with me here. Now, when Satan attacks, he attacks what? Your weak spot, which is the idle mind. Okay? So, when he begins to speak, you do what you did with that banana. Okay? Immediately, start thinking about that apple. Your mind cannot be idle if you're praising and meditating on God's Word. It cannot be idle. Therefore, you just slam the door right on Satan's face. Banana out, apple in. Simple as that. You know, I know this is probably sounding more like a Bill Gates message, but I try to find ways to where, you know, folks can, you know, relate. And, you know, one last thing while I'm at it, you know, Satan can always delete the icon. But, see, that system, that program is still in the system. And the motherboard, the hard drive, CPU, is still there. And I wanted to mention the very best virus or spyware protection for your system is not Norton, it's not McAfee, or it's not ABG. It's called the Holy Spirit. And I do highly recommend that you run a comprehensive scan each and every single day. And, well, I just want to thank y'all once again for watching. And hopefully I kept you around that long. And don't forget that I love you. And by all means, don't forget that Jesus loves you. So, you know, I want you to keep that system running smooth. And, and don't forget, block all of Satan's emails. and just block his address, because it's not worth reading anyway.